This program provides education, not advice. Sponsors pay a fee for endorsements and interviews. See the truthayf.com disclosure page for details.
This is where technology, innovation, and personal finance come together.
This is The Truth About Your Future with Rick Edelman. Brought to you by Global X ETFs, dedicated to providing investors with unexplored intelligent solutions, and by Invesco QQQ. Anyone can become an agent of innovation with Invesco QQQ, Invesco Distributors, Inc.
It's Wednesday, September 6th. Do you have a will? Well, I hope you do, although less than half of Americans actually do, but let's assume that you do have a will. Is that will going to successfully pass your stuff to your heirs as you hope that it will? In other words, the purpose of a will is to answer one and only one simple question. Who gets what? That's really why you write a will. You stipulate who your heirs are and what they each receive from your assets, your overall possessions. And a lot of people assume that, well, gee, since I've gone to the trouble of writing a will, whoever I said in the will is to inherit whatever it is I'd said they're to inherit, then no problem, right? Actually, you might be surprised. There was a survey of 443 wills that were probated in San Francisco over a three-year period. 12% of those wills went into litigation. Why might that be? Well, number one, an heir claiming that the deceased was wrongly influenced by a different heir, or perhaps other family member, or maybe even the executor or trustee of the estate. And that wrongful influence caused them to change who gets what. And if somebody feels they didn't get as much as they should have gotten, or wanted to get, or thought they would get, they're going to sue. Another reason people sue is because they argue somebody, somewhere, took advantage of the deceased's incapacity. You know, dad had dementia, Alzheimer's, or some other limiting mental capacity, and he didn't know what he was signing. Again, partly due to wrongful influence. And finally, another big reason, people are concerned about the suitability of the executor. If you've got three children and you name one of them as the executor, the other two children might not be satisfied with that decision. They might argue that there's favoritism involved, that the child you chose doesn't have the skills or the ability or isn't willing to take the time to make effective decisions regarding the estate's disposition. You might think this is all very simple. You own a house, you're going to leave the house to your children, but that house has to get sold. And that's the responsibility of the executor. Do they know how to sell a house to maximize its value? And how do you determine which offer to take? Do you take the low all-cash offer or the higher offer that is contingent on financing? Do you spend $50,000 at the suggestion of the real estate agent to spruce the house up, to repaint and recarpet, to maximize the ultimate sales potential of the house? This is complicated stuff. And if you end up selling the house for less than what some of the heirs think the house ought to have been sold for, the result is litigation. We need to recognize that this kind of thing happens a lot. I was just talking with a good friend of mine who has the unfortunate luck to be the executor of somebody's estate. You know, there's a joke in estate planning circles, if you have an enemy, make them your executor. It's a thankless job. It involves hours and hours of work over a year or two. You're generally not paid, although the executor can choose to be paid if they wish. And they have personal unlimited liability. So if there is a lawsuit involved, that executor or trustee could face personal financial risk based on the decisions, the actions they take or fail to take. Anyway, there was this one particular will that this person was dealing with, and none of the deceased's siblings received anything in the will. That is ripe for litigation. This is a common mistake people make in their wills. If you are estranged from your family, there's no law that says you have to leave them anything in your will. But if you leave them nothing, a very common lawsuit is, He forgot to include me in the will. It wasn't his intention to exclude me. And this is why a lot of estate lawyers say, if you want to exclude someone from the will, don't do that. Include them, but just leave them only $10. That will show that you deliberately chose how much to leave them. And then while you're at it, record a video of yourself reciting the fact that you are leaving them only $10. And you might even want to mention why, to reduce any likelihood that a court would say, we agree with the plaintiff, the deceased forgot. So, just because you have a will doesn't mean all your estate planning problems are over. You need to make sure that you are minimizing the likelihood of litigation. Marilyn Monroe's will is still being litigated. How many decades later? You certainly don't want that to be an experience your family goes through. Make sure you're getting good legal advice from an attorney who specializes in estate planning. I'm Rick Edelman. See you tomorrow.
Buzz around artificial intelligence is seemingly everywhere. Is your portfolio keeping up? Consider the Global X Artificial Intelligence and Technology ETF, ticker AIQ, which invests in dozens of stocks at the leading edge of this disruption. Investing involves risk, including possible loss of principal. Technology companies can be affected by rapid product obsolescence and intense industry competition. Before investing, carefully consider the fund's objectives, risks, charges, expenses, and more in the full or summary prospectus at globalxetfs.com. Read carefully. Distributed by SEI Investments Distribution Co.
Where do you store your important documents? How do you keep track of what you have or where it is? Use Presidio, the digital vault where you can collect, protect, and share all your important people, places, things, and documents with all the key people in your life. What you have and where you have it. You'll always know where your valuable information is kept, and you can easily and securely share your info anytime with anyone you choose. Try Presidio free today at Presidio.com. That's Presidio.com. Presidio.
Making the complex simple. Insights you can only get right here.
This is the truth about your future with Rick Edelman.